Ce gars.
Just make sure you watch each other's backs in the storeroom. Wouldn't want to lose my loyal customers.
Amir, there was a shrine about a giant lady, lots of books and visions.
Ah, that would be Gloa, the Knowledge Keeper. She was a gifted sorceress, who gathered every tome of arcane wisdom she could find in the realms, all in the hopes of augmenting her powers of prophecy, that she might find her lost husband, Arvandil. But it was not her husband she would glimpse in her visions. For it was Gloa, seeing longer and farther than any before or since, who witnessed Ragnarok, the end and the beginning. And Odin caught word of her ultimate prophecy. He maneuvered to obtain her knowledge and hoard it for himself. Gloa knew Odin as a longtime patron of her services, and so she welcomed him into her library as a friend. What she did not know is that Odin himself was behind her husband's disappearance, having used his enchantments to conceal his death at Thor's hands from her sight. Smiling, jealous Odin took her by the throat, and with his very hands he stole her library and her life for his own.
I always knew Odin was bad, but that's just...
ruthless, barbaric, heartless? That's Odin. In fact, we would do well to sit here in silence for the next few moments and reflect on Odin's capacity for cruelty. And so...
reflect longer.
Thank you.
Hey, look. A torch.
A torch is built with wood. That is a brazier.
A brazier. Looks like there's something written on it. Want me to read it? You're dead?
You're very perceptive and reckless. Take caution when lighting these braziers. Sather and Hellwalkers will swarm to the flames like moths. I assume we have you to thank for freeing us from a watery grave.
Us?
Other spirits. The Lake of Nine is full of them. Most are able to move on from this realm. But we, lucky few, are stuck here in Midgard. Until our affairs are in order. Perhaps you can help them as well.
We have no desire to help you, Spirit.
Ah, but you already have.
Whoa, he disappeared.
Come, let us not be distracted.
Thank you.
I guess we should keep an eye out for other spirits.
What did I say about distractions?
But it sounds like they needed help.
They are spirits, boy. Dead things. They have no needs, only wants.
It feels wrong to ignore them.
We will get over these feelings.
Mom would have wanted to help them.
What was that, boy?
Nothing.
I thought as much.
I see something down there. I have a question. If Ymir was the first giant, where did he come from?
In the beginning, there was Gnúmgagoth, the Great Void. There were no realms yet, only primordial forces. There was fire, and there was ice. And there in the void, they met and produced...
water?
More than water. The mystic lifeblood of something entirely new. From this water, Ymir took form and became a being of pure creation and chaos, mother and father to all that came after.
Even the Aesir?
Aye. Every god, man, and beast came first from Ymir's flesh. Though it was the Aesir who thought themselves so superior that they should hold dominion over the rest of creation. It was Odin who took arms against his creator and spilled Ymir's lifeblood with his spear. A necessary evil, he would say, to bring order to the realms. From Ymir's torn flesh, Odin would fashion the realm of Midgard for his own. Called himself All-Father, as if he was the creator, and not the creator's destroyer. A small, covetous tyrant!
Ymir?
Huh? Oh. Sorry, my boy. You know, I think it best we just end it there, actually.
down there. You want to beach here?